Good afternoon. This is Ben Ryan, and I'm here with my new colleagues, former Secretary of Energy Spencer Abraham and Joe McMonagle. Secretary Abraham is a member of the Board of Directors of Occidental Petroleum, NRG Energy, and PBF Energy. He served as the 10th Secretary of Energy in the United States, 10th Secretary of Energy in the United States from 2001 to 2005 under President Bush. Mr. McMonagle served as Chief of Staff for the U.S. Department of Energy, and also as the American co-chair of the U.S.-China Energy Cooperation Group. Where do you view the direction of oil prices into the spring? Does the 700,000 incremental barrels mean lower prices, or are there other factors internationally that are weighed against this 700,000?
Obviously, we think it's bearish for oil prices. I do believe that there's a lot of difference of opinion, as I'm sure everybody on this call knows, about how much and how quickly Iran can bring to market. So I don't think, it's really Iranian exports are priced into the market. I think, we're going to, even though we knew implementation day was coming last week, oil prices started tanking on Monday. So. I think when the stuff starts becoming very real, I think it's going to put further downward pressure on prices. I think the only thing that could potentially counterbalance that would be some kind of new evidence of Chinese demand or something like that. But really, until we start seeing towards the end of the summer U.S. production, decreasing, by large numbers, I think we're going to be in a very weak period here for oil prices.
I just would add, I think, if the analysis is confined to Iran and its implications, then as we said, the impact will be bearish, and because of the underestimation in terms of the time frame, it's probably a little part of the reason this week went as it went. But there are other factors that are going to be coming into play. We have for some time stuck to the notion that there isn't going to be a policy shift in Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, and therefore there isn't going to be a policy shift in terms of OPEC production. We stick with that, and if you combine that with Iran coming back, then it continues to have downward pressure. Some think that emergency meetings could result in changes with respect to OPEC positioning. We do not think that will be the case, and so the prospects for the marketplace based on not just Iran but the rest of the market I think together are consistent with bearish predictions at least into the spring.